We did get a lot of things explained that I think we've been waiting for, like little Ricky, like the gnomes. Hello, it's Kristen, and today we're talking about all the big revelations we learned in the final chapter of On My Block. We're talking about the 2-year time jump, who is little Ricky, the gnomes, what happened to the Roller World money, and where does everyone end up in the final episode? Consider subscribing if you like my videos and drop it in the comments and share some of your theories and thoughts on this final season of On My Block. And without further ado, let's get into it. First up, let's talk about the 2-year time jump. At the end of season 3, we see the core four are no longer friends. With the help of flashbacks, we learn what happened to break up their group. Ruby and Jamal turn on Caesar because they think he and Spooky took the Roller World money.
Come on, Caesar. Don't play dumb. Either he stole it or you both did.
Wouldn't be the first time you two ran game on us. Santos for life, right?
Monse and Caesar separate because Monse doesn't agree with Caesar getting into the gang lifestyle, and Caesar also doesn't want to see her get hurt by it. Ruby and Jamal break apart because Ruby is always with Jasmine, you know, a classic case of just being too focused on a relationship. Meanwhile, Jamal accidentally gets a butt dial from Monse ragging on her professor, and he thinks that she's talking about him. Since then, he's cut her out of his life. I thought this was just super realistic to see that their friendship was fractured really by distance, miscommunications, new relationships. But that once they got back together again, they were able to put it all behind them eventually and work together as a team. Next up, who is Little Ricky is finally explained. Little Ricky really took on the role of like a legendary mythological character when it came to On My Block. He had such a legacy as this mysterious founder of the Santos gang who hid the Roller World money in 1981. It was believed that he passed away after stealing and hiding the Roller World money, but later it was revealed that he was alive but in hiding. There was a lot of theories as to who Little Ricky was. From Father Goose to Caesar and Spooky's dad, even Monse's dad, Chivo. The other theory that I think could actually be really plausible is that Little Ricky is actually that guy in Bakersfield that Ray is reaching out to because this is a man who gives inmates a second chance. And I think that's actually something that ties in really well with what we know about Little Ricky as a character. He was a guy who wouldn't hurt a fly. He wanted to help people in the gang life. And to see that there is some character out there that we haven't met yet that Ray knows that is trying to help people and give them a second chance, I feel like that could definitely be Little Ricky.
What we end up learning in this final season is that Little Ricky is the owner of a rehab center in Bakersfield called The Farm. Back in season 3, we actually get a hint of this as Oscar and Caesar's dad talks about how he fled to Bakersfield when an unknown man offered him a job. Now we know that that unknown man was Little Ricky, and that's who he's been working for. Caesar is the one who ends up finding Little Ricky as he gets help getting his car running by a man played by Cesar Garcia, who introduces himself as Ricky Galindo. And as expected, Jamal freaks out to finally meet his hero. He has a million and one questions for him. And really, it just comes down to Ricky seeming to be like a regular guy who got caught up with this money and was sort of being selfish about it and ultimately ended up losing friendships because of it. And I think it just kind of goes back to that whole idea of friendship being just a really strong focus, an important aspect of the show. And of course, we got to talk about the gnomies. We were first introduced to the gnomes of On My Block by Shivo. We learn that the gnomes are all named after fallen members of the Santos and that they seem to have some kind of magical properties, if you will. But then after RIP Oscar's death, we meet a spooky gnome. And it seems like these gnomes are not just named after the fallen Santos, but are actually the spirits of them as well. I feel like there's a whole lot more lore there that I would love to dive into. And now that we are getting that Free Ridge spinoff show and they hinted that the gnomies will be back, I'm hoping that we get to learn more there. And hey, maybe if we're lucky, we'll even get like a gnome spinoff show. I just think that there's something really magical and exciting going on with those gnomes. And we got to get into the Roller World money. Since the first season of On My Block, the Roller World money has been such a huge focus as Jamal was basically going on this Goonies type adventure searching for this money that Little Ricky stole and hid. He finds the money, the core four wash it. It seems like all is going well until the money goes missing. That leads to that fractured core four relationship with Jamal and Ruby really being convinced that Spooky and Caesar were up to no good when it came to that money.
We see them confront Caesar in a flashback, and then in another flashback, Caesar accuses Oscar of stealing the money. But if you remember, the last person to be in possession of the real world money was Oscar while he was getting fixed up by Abuelita. At the end of the season, though, it seems like maybe Abuelita was actually the one who took the money, hiding it for the Core Four and setting up a scavenger hunt for them to find it in the final episode. And finally, now from student council elections to prom to graduation, it is officially time to say goodbye to our favorite Free Ridge crew. So this is what they end up being up to at the end of the season. Jasmine and Ruby do end up together. It looks like Jasmine is going to go to Berkeley and Ruby's going to go to his dream college, Stanford. Jamal, who has feared that someone has been following him this season, turns out to be right. Kendra returns, and we learn that she's actually been the one keeping tabs on him as the head intern for Noel Aroma, the Fortune 500 tech billionaire. Noel is fascinated by his quirky, inventive side and offers Jamal a job after high school, which he accepts, and he finally feels like he's found his purpose. Monse has finally read her mom's book, learns a lot more about who she was, why she left, and she shares everything that she learned with her dad and Brian, and they agree to move past all that drama and become a family again. And at Abuelita's memorial party, she reveals that she's going to be going to the all-women's college, Wesleyan, but before that, she's going to take a gap year to write a memoir about all that they've gone through. And then following Spooky's death, Caesar is finally out of the gang life. I just wish it didn't take Spooky's death to make that happen, but he finally feels like he has a future, and he's going to go to Portland to go to community college. He's going to go stay with his sister-in-law and help raise his baby niece. They also do hint that maybe Monse and Caesar could find a way to be together now. And after Ruby wins prom king, which honestly, how funny was that reaction when he won? Oh my goodness. But the friends end up heading back to Ruby's house for an after party. And unfortunately, they find out that Abuelita has passed away from cancer. Everyone reunites once more at her memorial party where they drink and smoke and celebrate her life. And they do sort of like a full circle moment where the friends see a group of kids looking over the fence into the backyard, just like they did in the first season. And finally, Abuelita's last gift for the Core Four is revealed by Ruby, and it's a map that I believe leads to the Roller World money. And the series ends with them trying to decide who is going to lead this new expedition. To me, what else could she possibly have left for them? The last time that we saw Spooky and Abuelita together, they had the Roller World money. I think it's a no-brainer that Abuelita must have taken that money and hidden it, told Oscar not to tell anybody, and that she was going to keep it for the Core Four until it was safe. Let me know if you have other thoughts, but I feel like that makes the most sense to me. And while this might be the end of the Core Four story, we will be headed back to Free Ridge with a new story in a newly announced spinoff on Netflix. So I'm crossing my fingers that maybe if we're lucky, there will be some cameo appearances from our current crew in that new series. I'd love to hear any thoughts, theories, maybe Easter eggs that you caught in this final season of On My Block. And if you guys like this one, you can check out more of my On My Block videos right over here, and I'll catch you in the next one. See ya.